and welcome to Valil Capital. I have done a video about the SIP and also about the mutual fund. So today's video is about the difference between the SIP and the mutual fund and also the 6 common myths of SIP investing busted. With increasing awareness among the people for savings, it is high time that the myths concerning the systematic investment plan investments are debunked. Investors often find themselves in a dilemma about whether to invest in SIP or whether to invest in the mutual fund. Many investors often ask for the historical performance and guaranteed returns under the SIP before committing an investment. The biggest misconception in the minds of the investors is that besides the mutual fund, SIP is an additional investment option for the investors. However, the investors must know that the mutual fund is an investment product enabling the investors to invest in a wide range of mutual fund scheme. As such, the investors may choose a desired mutual fund scheme which best suits their investment plans and also the financial goals. On the other hand, the SIP is not an investment product but a convenient option to invest in the mutual fund. One may invest in mutual funds in a lump sum or through SIP. Lump sum investing refers to investing in one go, wherein the investors make an investment with a mutual fund in a single instance. In contrast, the SIP allows the investors to commit the regular investments with the mutual funds. Let us bust 6 common SIP myths one by one. SIP is an investment product by itself. The financial advisors usually encounter the questions like, which is the best SIP? Or what return will a SIP give, etc. When people encounter the concept of SIP investment for the first time, they often tend to believe that some investment product is being pitched to them. However, they must realize that some investment product is being pitched to them. However, they must realize that it is not an investment product but instead an investment facility which allows the investors to make a regular investment. When one registers a mutual fund SIP, it must be registered along with the name of the mutual fund scheme as well as the periodicity. Thereafter, the investment amount will be deducted automatically from your bank account and invested in the pre-specified mutual fund scheme. SIP guarantees the positive returns in investment. Ensuring the guaranteed positive returns in your investments is always an investor's preference. They tend to consider investing in SIPs as a guaranteed measure to eliminate the risk of negative returns. However, it seems even SIPs are prone to negative returns even while they mitigate such risk over the long term as they make investments across the market trends. Investing through SIP provides the benefit of rupee cost averaging to the investors, which means that the cost of investments gets averaged through the market ups and downs. Further, the historical analysis of Chrysler AMFI Equity Fund Performance Index over the last 15 years that the instance of negative returns reduced to zero with a SIP investment period of 5 years and more. As such, while investing through SIPs may not guarantee any positive returns, the financial discipline of investing through SIPs may help the investors mitigate the risk of negative returns. SIP is only for small investors. SIPs are generally promoted as a medium to make the savings even as low as Rs. 500. As such, it is often felt that the SIP may be registered only for making small ticket investments on a regular basis. However, this is not true, and the investors may register SIP for any amount as they may prefer on the higher side. In fact, a substantial SIP installment amount may help that the investor accumulate a substantial amount towards their financial goals in the longer run. SIP may be done only for equity funds. One may believe that SIP is to be done only for equity funds. SIP may be done only for equity funds. One may believe that the SIP is to be done only for equity funds, as such funds are more prone to market volatility. However, investing through the SIP is equally beneficial in debt funds as well. Investing in the debt funds through SIP is to open a recurring deposit with banks but with the potential of better returns. SEBI allows a wide range of equity and debt schemes to be offered by the mutual funds. Even within the bucket of the debt funds, one may choose to invest in yield funds, duration funds, credit risk funds, etc., depending upon their risk appetite and also upon the return expectations. SIP should be done during the bull market. People often tend to be emotional during the market movements. The fear of investing at higher valuations and then generating the negative returns may cause the investors to stop their SIPs while the markets are rising. Especially since they will receive a lower number of units per SIP installment. However, they must realize that the SIP is a medium to invest across the market directions. Stopping fresh investments may cause the investors to miss an opportunity to gain from further market rallies. Further, SIP is itself an investment facility to eliminate the emotional bias in investing, and using your emotions for your investment decisions may adversely affect the investment journey. SIP investment may not be modified once registered. One may be in dilemma while registering an SIP, as such registration may call for long-term commitment towards investing regularly. However, it is indeed the beauty of SIP investing that the investor enjoys the liberty to stop the SIP and register a new SIP with a modified periodicity amount and even the mutual fund scheme. As such, the SIP allows complete flexibility to the investor to make the changes to their investment plan. So now that you have cleared your doubts about investing in mutual fund through SIP, take a step ahead towards investing right away and also start investing towards your financial goals. So I hope that everybody understood about today's topic. If you people are having any doubt, you can comment in our comment box. Our experts will be replying for your comment within a minute. As saying always, please share our video with your friends, relatives, and also don't forget to subscribe our channel. And if you people are watching our video for the first time, please hit the bell button too. Stay safe, stay home, stay healthy. Thank you.